Today let's learn about optimality test. The optimality condition or the optimality test can be applied onto any IBFS. IBFS is initial basic feasible solution, and as we know, initial basic feasible solution can be found using any of the methods, like we have NWCR or LCM or even WAM. Any of the three methods we can use and find the IBFS. And once we have found the actual initial basic feasible solution, we can test for optimality. Just that it has to satisfy the condition that m plus n minus 1 should be same as the number of allocations. That means to say the solutions that we have obtained, the solution that we have obtained has to be a non-degenerate solution. If we have a non-degenerate solution, then only we can apply the optimality test. So optimality test can be done in many methods, and one of the major famous method is called as Modi method. In short, it is actually modified distribution method. So Modi method is the first method, and also we have stepping stone method. So today let us learn Modi method. Let us start with Modi method. In short, it is generally called as Modi, but it is the modified distribution method. And this method follows few steps. So I will just explain the steps first and then explain with an example. First of all, we are supposed to find the IBFS. So in the first step, we find the IBFS. We all know that it is initial basic feasible solution, and it can be found using any of the basic methods called as NWCR, LCM or WAM. And once we arrive at the IBFS, we can apply the actual optimality test. So what do we do in step number 2 is, for any occupied cell, so I would just show you a situation. If we have something like this, we have some value which is assigned here, and we have a cell here where we don't have any allotment. Similarly, here also we have some value, but there is no allocation. And if we assume that there is some value here, so these are called as occupied cells and these are called as unoccupied cells. So we actually find out numbers called as ui and vj for all the occupied cells. So that is the most important thing, and it has to satisfy a condition, that is your cij should be equal to your ui and vj. This is one condition that we check, and this is your cij. Cij is the inside value that we have. So we are supposed to calculate few numbers called ui and vj, where they satisfy that cij equal to ui plus vj. This is one thing. And we have a situation where we don't have an allocation. This is called as an unoccupied cell, and for an unoccupied cell we calculate something called as delta ij. So this delta ij can be found as cij minus ui minus vj. And once we calculate the cij's and ui vj, sorry, delta ij using cij minus ui minus vj, we get three conditions. That is, our delta ij can be greater than 0. That means to say we have an optimal solution and this is a unique solution that we have obtained. Also a situation where your delta ij can be greater than or equal to 0. That means to say still we have the optimum solution, but an alternate solution may exist. That is the second situation. And the third situation is that your delta ij can be less than 0. That means to say, if we have any one of the unoccupied cell having a negative number, that means we are supposed to improve the TTC. Whatever that we have got, we are supposed to improve so that we get a better TTC. So to improvise, we have few steps that has to be followed. So we have delta ij to be less than 0. That is, it is a negative value. So we are supposed to start from the most negative cell that we have got. That means to say, when you have delta ij, you might have more than one also as a negative number. So choose the most negative number, and we draw a closed path from that particular cell onto the other cells wherever we have an allocation. That is the condition. So stop at the position where we have an allocation. That means to say all the corner points are having the allocation, and we start with the most negative delta ij. So after drawing the closed path, we assign the symbol like plus minus, that is alternating signs of plus and minus. So we have plus and minus, and after doing this, we choose the most smallest number, that is minimum of minus theta. So we just name them as theta. So we find the theta values here, and we choose the minimum of minus theta. Once we get the minimum of minus theta, assume whatever value that we get, in the revised matrix, we actually write wherever we have plus theta, we add the smallest number. Wherever we have minus theta, we subtract the value. So this brings us to a situation where few values will enter in, and one value has to go out. That is the major idea behind this. And after the revised matrix, we again start with calculating the step 2, that is find out our ui vj values, then find out delta ij. Again, if we have all the delta ij's to be positive, then we have attained at the optimal solution, we calculate the TTC. So I would explain the same steps with an example. Consider the first problem here. We are supposed to first notice that for the following TP, find the IBFS, and here they have mentioned the method. So be very careful. They are particular that we are supposed to use the NWCR method. And look at the question. They have not stopped at this. They are asking you to find out the optimal solution. That means to say we apply the Modi method to find the optimal solution. And there is an extra part in the question that we would come back to it at the end. It says that whether the value that we have obtained in IBFS is differing from the actual Modi method that we have found. So I'll come back to this at the end. Now the question given is solve the TP, but we are supposed to find the IBFS using only NWCR method and also continue or extend it to the optimal solution. So look at the question here. We can see that we have O1, O2, O3, O4, that is the four rows that we have given, that is origin, and we have ABC. The set of values are given, we have required and the available. And we all know that the first condition before even we start to solve the TP is to check whether the values of all the available and required are matching. That means the sigma AI and sigma BJ we are supposed to find out. So now look at the question. We have 10 plus 10 and 8, it becomes 28. Here also, this is 28. So we have the condition that sigma AI is matching with sigma BJ. Hence, it is a balanced TP. Therefore, the solution exists. Now, we have the first basic condition that we have found out that the available and required are matching. That means to say we can go ahead and find the actual IBFS. We find the IBFS using NWCR. So the left topmost corner we are supposed to start. We have 8 and 10, the least being 8, and this gets cancelled. We have 2 remaining here. Now the remaining cell, we have the left topmost corner, 2 and 7, 2 being the least, this gets cancelled, and we have 5 more here. Now among them, left topmost is this. We have 10 and 5, so 5 is the least, this gets cancelled. We have 5 more here. Again, remaining left topmost, 5 and 9, we give 5 because this is the least, and 4 is remaining. And these two cells, the left topmost is this only. So 4 and 8, I can give 4 because that is the least, and 4 is remaining. And we all know that in NWCR method, at the last cell, we get the available and required to be matching. So the last cell being the value 4. We cancel. So once we finish the actual allocation and it is balanced, we are supposed to calculate the TTC, and TTC will be 8 into 10, that is wherever we have the allocation only, we are supposed to consider that particular cell. We have 2 into 12 plus 5 into 7, again plus 5 into 9, 4 into 7 plus 4 into 10, and the total TTC we get is 252. So this becomes the TTC after we calculate the actual values that is being given. And before even we go forward for optimality test, we are supposed to check if m plus n minus 1 condition is satisfied or not. This should be same as number of allocations. So in this case, we have 4 rows, 3 columns minus 1. So this becomes 6. And we can check here that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So that is again same as the number of allocations. Hence, it is non-degenerate. This is the first condition to be satisfied before we go to the. So, since it is non-degenerate, we can apply the Modi method. Now, how do we start with the Modi method? The same actual matrix has to be copied down, but don't use all the cross lines and all. That means to say we actually write the weighted matrix and the allocation cells for the next step. So, copy the same matrix that you have obtained after performing the NWCR, LCM or VAM. That means to say the IBFS cell, whatever the matrix that we get, the same matrix has to be copied back. I have just copied the IBFS solution that we have obtained. Now we are supposed to start with calculating the values called as Ui and Vj. How do we do this? Ui and Vj is Cij minus Ui should give you Vj, or ulta, Cij minus Vj would give us Ui. So we are supposed to start with the initial value called as 0. Actually, 0 can be put wherever we have more number of allocations. So in this case 2 and 5, we have 2 allocations, you can start with a 0 here. Or you have 2 allocations here, you can start with a 0. You have 2 allocations here, you can start with a 0. So, but still, you can use 0 anywhere also, still you can obtain the answer. I would show both the ways. Now, initially, I will start from here. Okay? Assume our initial value called as 0. Now, wherever we have an occupied cell, we can see here that 8, 2, 5, 5, 4, 4. These are the values that we have in the occupied position. So, wherever we have the occupied cell, there only we are supposed to calculate the Ui and Vj. So that is the only condition, and always follow inside minus outside. So always remember that you have to do inside minus the outside value. So now I'll start. 10 minus 0 is 10. Now actually you can check back in the same column you have any other allocation. We have it here. So it becomes 12 minus 10, which is 2. Again we have one more allocation here. 7 minus 2 becomes 5, 9 minus 5 becomes 4, 7 minus 4 becomes 3, and 10 minus 3 becomes 7. Now we can see that all the rows and columns have got the Ui Vj values. This is one of the method, and now I will start with an initial value 0 here. We can still follow the same thing. Inside minus outside, only the allocation cells have the value. So 12 minus 0 becomes 12, and I can see that there is a allocation here. So 10 minus 12, 10 minus 12 inside minus outside becomes minus 2. Again, I have an occupied cell here. So 7 minus 0 is 7. 9 minus 7 becomes 2. 7 minus 2 becomes 5. And 10 minus 5 is 5. Again, we can see that we have obtained the value. So I would just revert back to the original style. That means I just would start with a 0 here. I would repeat, this is just a repetition for you to understand it better. Occupied cells only are to be used, and inside minus outside is the policy. So 10 minus 0 becomes 10, 12 minus 10 is 2, 7 minus 2, 5, 9 minus 5, 4, 7 minus 4, 3, and 10 minus 3 becomes 7. So these are the values that we get for Ui and Vj. This is using the occupied cells. Now we can see that there are some cells which have no allocation, correct? These are all called as the unoccupied cells. So for any unoccupied cell, we are actually calculate the delta ij. How do we find delta ij? It is Cij minus Ui minus Vj. So what do we do? Cij is the inside value, you know Ui value, and you know Vj value. Now for this particular cell, we don't have an allocation. So what do we do is Cij minus Ui minus Vj. I just show for one or two values, Cij minus Ui and minus Vj. So answer is 4. Now use this number in the right hand side of the cell, because we have majority different numbers. So kindly give the position. All these numbers you can write at the right corner, and the location on the left, and you can write the parenthesis value, that is delta ij, within the parenthesis on the right hand side. Now we have the next value. This is also an unoccupied cell, so we follow Cij minus Ui minus Vj. This gives us 5. So this is 5 here in the parenthesis. Now this is an unoccupied cell. I would do it directly. Cij minus Ui minus Vj. So 10 minus 2 is 8. 8 minus 3 becomes 5. Write the value here. Now 11 minus 4 is 7, but 7 minus 10 is minus 3. This is our first enemy in the box, correct? So we have 11 minus 4, which is 7. 7 minus 10 gives you minus 3. Now you have one more unoccupied cell, that is 12. 12 minus 7 gives you 5, but 5 minus 10 is one more enemy, minus 5 here. Okay. And this is again an unoccupied cell. 14 minus 7 is 7. 7 minus 5 is 2. So So according to the algorithm, if you have all the parentheses, that is your delta ij values to be positive, you can stop. But in this case, we can see that we have negative numbers. And if you have more than one negative number, you're supposed to choose the most negative number. And in this case, we can see that we have the most negative number as minus 5. So from here, we are supposed to draw a closed path, okay, using the vertical and the horizontal lines. You are not supposed to use any tapered line, that is a slanting line. You are supposed to use only horizontal and vertical lines and create a path. Majority of the times, path could be of this kind where we have the 6 points. It is always a closed path, so obviously you will get even number or maybe a 4 point structure. That is also possible. So you are supposed to start from the most negative number. And you are supposed to stop where you have an allocation. These are like, you know, steps. You are supposed to stop only when you have a step there. So you can actually stop wherever you have the allocation and try to find the loop. Now in this case, I can see that start from the most negative number. Stop wherever you have an allocation. Stop where you have an allocation. Stop where you have an allocation. Again, stop where you have allocation. Stop where you have allocation and come back to the same point. This is the loop. Now you can ask me a question, why did we not actually use, there is no hard and fast rule that for every allocation you stop, right? So why did I not stop at 8? Because if I extend this line, I don't have any other junction to come to this side. So I'll have to use a tapered line or a slanting line. That is not permitted. You're supposed to use a closed loop with only horizontal and vertical lines. So we have obtained the actual loop. So the looping again I would explain, start with the most negative number, stop wherever you have an allocation, stop where you have allocation, come back to the same position, but wherever we stop, we are supposed to have an allocation. So this forms the actual closed loop. Once the loop is made, wherever we started, this is supposed to be given with a sign called plus. So alternatingly we write plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. So for easiness, we also add a variable called as theta here. You can use any other variable, of course, and not necessary also. So plus theta, this becomes minus theta. This is plus, this is, sorry, minus theta. This is plus theta. This is minus theta. And wherever we started, we come back to plus theta. So alternatingly, I have given the actual symbols. And you can see that we started with the most negative number. So this becomes your plus, minus, and alternatingly plus, minus is written. Now, in the next step, you are supposed to choose the minimum of minus theta. That means to say, whatever is the allocation, look at the values that you have in the allocation cell. So, we can see that we have a minus theta here. The value in the allocation place is 2. Similarly, we have minus theta, we have the value as 5. Then we have minus, we have the value as 4. So, now we can see that we have, since it is a 6-point loop, we have 3 plus symbols and 3 minus symbols. Now choose the minimum of minus theta. In this case, we have 2, 5 and 4 and we can see that the minimum being 2. So this is the least value that we are supposed to actually write in the revised matrix. So because of space, I'm going to erase this and copy the next revised matrix here. So what happens here is whenever you have, after you find the minimum value, when you have a plus symbol, this gets a new allocation called as 2. This is minus, so 2 minus 2 becomes 0. So the rule says one has to enter and at least one has to vanish. In this case, we can see the plus gets a new allocation and this is not going to be written back because minus becomes 0. Now we have 8 which is untouched. So repeat back the value, whatever is there, because we did not touch in the loop, we did not touch 8. So 8 is repeated back. Now you can see that you have a plus symbol here. So 5 plus 2 becomes 7. You have minus, so 5 minus 2 is 3. This is plus, it becomes 6. It becomes minus, you get 2. So I repeat, after making the loop, give the alternate symbol as plus, minus, plus, minus. Choose the minimum of minus thetas. We are not interested in Cij, it is the allocation value that is there. So you have 2, 5 and 4. Among them, 2 is the least. So now I write the revised matrix using the policy of plus and minus. Now after making the loop, plus minus symbol, we actually chose the most negative theta value, that is 2, 5, 4. We found that 2 is the least. Now this is the revised matrix. I've just made a matrix where is the other part, but you can keep it back as it is. Now you can see that the 8 is not being touched at all in the loop. So I repeat back 8 as an allocation, no change in this. Now, we started here with the most negative number. The rule says wherever you have plus theta, add this 2. So, that means to say you get a new allocation called as 2 for this position since this is the plus theta. Now, we have minus theta here. It has nothing to do with the parenthesis value. These values are just a decision makers. Don't worry about that value here. Now, in this case 12, we have 2, but there's a symbol which is called as minus. That means to say minimum is 2. So, 2 minus 2 becomes 0 and one of the element is getting vanished. So, you have a new entry and one exit. That is the rule. At least you can have 2 entries, but at least one value has to vanish. That is go out. So, you plus theta got a 2 and minus theta got a minus symbol. So, 2 minus 2 became 0. Now, this is plus theta. So, 5 plus 2 becomes 7. This is the allocation here. Then you have minus theta. So, 5 minus 2 becomes 3. So, I get 3 in this place. Now, plus theta, so 4 plus 2 becomes 6 here. Now, you have minus theta, so 4 minus 2 becomes 2. So, now you can check back. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We started with 6 allocation. You have 6 allocation. So, in the revised table, I have just started with plus theta, new allocation. Minus means subtraction. Plus, 5 plus 2 is 7. Here, minus, so it became 3. It is plus, so it became 6. And it is minus, so we have got 2. So, once we have the revised matrix with us, again we are supposed to start with ui vj, because the decision factor for us to stop or get the optimal solution is with the value of delta ij. We are supposed to get all delta ij's to be positive. So, I start with ui vj. Again, I told you wherever you have more number of values, you can put a 0 and start, or instead I would start with here only. So, inside minus outside, be careful, you might get a negative number also for this. So, 10 minus 0 is 10. I can see I have an allocation here. So, 12 minus 10 is 2. I can see an allocation. 10 minus 2 is 8. 7 minus 8 is minus 1. Be careful. Now, I have an allocation here. So, 9 minus of minus 1. Please be careful when you have a negative number. So, 9 minus of minus 1 becomes 10. I have 7 here. So, 7 minus 10, 7 minus 10 becomes minus 3. Now, you can see all are occupied. I just repeat, you start with an initial value called 0. Wherever you have occupied cell only, you are supposed to follow the Cij minus Ui minus Vj policy. So, 10 minus 0 is 10, 12 minus 10 is 2, 10 minus 2 is 8, 7 minus 8 is minus 1, 9 minus of minus 1 becomes 10, 7 minus 10 is minus 3. So, you have got all the values of Ui and Vj. So, this is only using the occupied cells. We have some more cells called as unoccupied. So, whichever is unoccupied, we are supposed to calculate the delta ij. And we know, how do we calculate delta ij? Delta ij will be Cij minus Ui minus Vj. This is the rule. So, I would start from here. Directly, I would do Cij minus Ui minus Vj. So, you can see 9 minus 0 minus 10. Now, what happened? You got your first enemy in the first cell itself. So, this becomes your minus 1. Now, 8 minus 0 and 8, again you get back 0. Nothing to write here. 12 minus of minus 3 is 15. 15 minus 10 becomes 5. 10 minus of minus 3 is 13. 13 and 8, again you have 5. 11 minus of minus 1 becomes 12. 12 minus 10 is 2 here. Then we have 14. 14 minus 2 is 12. 12 minus 10 is 2. So, now we have to check if all our parentheses, that is delta ij, is positive or negative. But in this case, we can clearly see that again we have got a negative number, that is minus 1. So, here you are supposed to again follow the looping structure, that is a closed path, using the vertical and horizontal lines. And wherever the rule says, wherever you stop, you are supposed to have an allocation. So, find a particular path, wherever you have an allocation, you are supposed to stop. So, we can just see that the loop is being from, start from here, because that is the most negative number, only one negative number. Stop where you have an allocation, stop where you have an allocation, stop where you have an allocation, stop, stop, and you can come back to the same place wherever you started. You can see here that we have biased this number, that is just, you can go back, you don't have to stop because it is a closed path and we are supposed to get only even numbers. So, I would repeat, most negative spot we started, stop where you have an allocation, come back, again you have an allocation, stop where you have an allocation, again I have stopped wherever I have an allocation, and come back. Don't consider this, it's okay, you can go straight. we neglected in the previous step the 8 because we will get a tapered line or a slanting line. In this case, the 7 can be just overlooked. After we write the closed loop, again start with the policy of writing the alternating symbols. Wherever you start, that becomes your plus theta. Wherever you start, that is plus theta. Alternate symbol, so this is minus theta. This becomes your plus theta. This is your minus theta. This is your plus theta, minus theta, and you're back to your plus theta. So after you find your plus and minus symbols, after you mark, you're supposed to choose the minimum of minus theta. That is the rule. So now you can see that since again it is a 6-point loop, you have 3 negative numbers, 3 negative positions. This is minus theta and the value here is 8. You are supposed to look at the allocation, not Cij. So you have minus here, the value here is again 2. Then you have a minus here, the value here is 3. Now among all this, we can again see that 2 is the least. Sometimes it is happening, that's all, but every time you need not get 2 only as your least value. So in this case, you can see that you started with most negative number, stopped wherever you had an allocation, correct? You got a 6-point value, that is a path. Now alternating symbols also we gave, and choose the minimum among all these minus numbers. So with the allocation, we found that 2 is the least. Now after the loop, and we found the 3 minus theta, so 2, 3 and 8, and we found that 2 is the minimum. Now I have written the revised matrix. And how do we do now? Here you can see that 7 is untouched by the points. The line is just passed, but 7 is not being touched. So I repeat back the value of 7. That doesn't change anything here. So 7 is same. Now we started from the most negative number, that is minus 1. We had only 1. So this becomes plus theta. So wherever we have plus theta, we are supposed to add the minimum value of theta. So we found that minimum value of theta was 2. Wherever it is plus, you're supposed to add. So here we get a new allocation called as 2. Now this is a minus symbol. So 8 minus 2 becomes 6. This is our next allocation. Now we have plus theta here. So 2 plus 2 becomes 4. Similarly, come back here. Now we can notice that this is a minus symbol, minus theta. So 2 minus 2 becomes 0. So according to the rule, one value will come newly and one value has to vanish. So in this case, you have minus theta, so 2 becomes 0. Now this is a plus theta, so 6 gets added with 2, so you get 8. And now this is minus theta, so 2, when you subtract, you get back 1. Again, you can check that you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 allocations. And how did we get this? After choosing the most negative theta, that is 2, we have added wherever we had the plus symbols, and we have subtracted the same 2 from the allocations wherever we had a minus symbol. And once we get the actual allocations, again we are supposed to check with UIVJ. We get all UIVJ to be ready and find the delta ij value. If delta ijs are positive, we stop, and since lack of space, I erase and then start with UIVJ. So I start with UI and VJ values for it. So we can see here that we have allocation maximum here, or again maximum here. You can start with the 0 here or here, anywhere. So I would just start with the first place only as usual. So 10 minus 0 gives me a value of 10. Now again there is an allocation. 12 minus 10 gives me 2. Here no more allocation is there, so I go back to the first row itself. So 10 minus 0 is 10, 12 minus 10 is 2, done. Now 9 minus 0 gives me a 9 here. 7 minus 9, it is again 7 minus 9, it becomes minus 2. Then I have 9 minus 9, which is 0 here. And 7 minus 0 is 7. Now we can see that every row and column has got with the values called UIVJ. Now it is our job to find out delta ij. We know that delta ij is nothing but Cij minus Ui minus Vj. That means for occupied cells, we followed the UIVJ trap. And now we are supposed to calculate for an unoccupied cell the delta ij. So in this case, we have to find out delta ij. So Cij minus Ui minus Vj. 8 minus 0 minus 7 gives me a 1 here. 12 minus of minus 2 becomes 14. 14 minus 10. So I get a 4 here. This is again an unoccupied cell. 10 minus of minus 2 becomes 12. 12 minus 7 gives me a 5 here. 11 minus 0 is 11, and minus 10 gives me a positive 1 here. Now 14 minus 2 is 12. 12 minus 9 becomes 3. 10 minus 2 is 8, 8 minus 7 gives me 1, and we can notice here that every delta ij value, that means all the parentheses here that we have obtained, are positive. So since we have all delta ij's to be positive, we have attained the optimal solution condition. Right? So the condition was, check for all your delta ij's. We could see that after drawing two different loops and revising the matrix twice, we got back the matrix where all the delta ij values are positive. Since they are positive, we have obtained the actual optimal solution. So how do we continue? This again looks like one of the IBFS matrix only. So we are supposed to calculate the TTC for the same problem. So after finding all this and the condition being satisfied, and we know that we have attained the optimal solution, we actually calculate the TTC for the problem. So the TTC here is, we have 6 into 10 plus 2 into 9 plus 7 into 7, 1 into 9 plus 8 into 7 plus 4 into 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 values. And the total TTC for this is 240. So we have obtained the actual optimal solution, and the optimal solution for this particular TP is 240. So this actually is the revised matrix and the solution that we have obtained. So what we did first the IBFS method, maybe using NWCR LCM map. The question that I have mentioned asked us to follow the NWCR method. So we followed NWCR, we obtained the IBFS as 252, and now after revising, that is applying the optimality test for it, that is Modi method, we have obtained a new TTC called as 240. Now go back to the question. The last line of the question just asked that, does the IBFS value differ from the actual optimal solution, or your optimal solution varies with your IBFS? We are supposed to just mention it. Yes, you can see here that you have got a better answer called as 240 compared to the original answer, which was 252. So what you have to do is, yes, the optimal solution differs from the IBFS by, and you can just remember that your IBFS value was 252 and now you have obtained 240, which is equal to 12. By 12, it is actually varied. This is just an extra touching question. You will have to be very careful when you read the question whenever given. These are all small questions that they would ask. So IBFS value majority of the times changes with your optimal solution. Obviously, this is to minimize the total transportation cost during the transportation process. So obviously you get a better improved or a lower value of your TTC compared to the actual IBFS. So this actually completes your Modi method.